Right, ladies and gentlemen, we're still waiting for commercial vehicles and also the miniature vehicles as well. They'll be joining us in the arena shortly, but we're just waiting for them to make their way through the site to get to the arena. Obviously, there's quite a few people on site now. They've got the gate open at 10 o'clock, so it's a bit crowded and it takes a little bit of time to get the vehicles into the arena. They generally park up in groups, so they tend to
We're just waiting on the commercial vehicles now, and the miniature vehicles. I'm not quite sure which are coming first, but we shall have the placing of those hopefully to the arena very shortly.
This is his service van. This gentleman goes on to sites, building sites, all sorts of construction sites to mend stuff, don't you? And you keep it lovely, don't you? Bit fanatical, aren't you? Yeah, Ford Transit, ladies and gentlemen. In the back, it's all kitted out. You can see the light bar on the roof, lights all over the place. And it's really nice to see these guys putting a lot of effort in and taking a pride in the vehicles and what they do. Thank you very much, mate.
Yeah.
Lovely, thanks for bringing it, mate. You got another Volvo FH. As you can see, different tacks on it. This is on scrap work. So this will be going into places again, which is very, very dirty, scrap yards and all sorts of places. To say what it does then, it's really, really tidy. What year is it? Oh, so this is a 12-plate as well again. It's 10 years old, but yeah, it doesn't look like that.
Thank you.
Sir William. He lines himself up. These lances are between 10 and 14 foot long. And he takes out the first one and the second one. Maximum 4 points there, Sir William. Next to go, it looks like we're going to have the turn of Sir Galahad. Sir Galahad and his horse Sorrow, they line up, they charge into it. And that's one, two, there's a full 4 points there as well for Sir Galahad. Next is going to be the turn of, who we got? It's our Queenie. Queenie riding her horse Batman. They're lined up, and it's two. There for Queenie. They're making this look so easy. I think next to go is going to be Sir Hasselhoff. Oh, 2 points there for Sir Hasselhoff. You've got to hit a bit harder, Sir Hasselhoff. Well, Joust. They're lined up. Better lance. I have to declare them with maximum points. Sir William is our winner today. Might have been a bit of a problem. And I think Sir William might have stolen your horse. You better go get it.
For some time. This one's been in preservation for quite a number of years now. It was very early engine in preservation. Travels everywhere on the road, and it has the name of I Can Hop It. Those little steam tracks, as the first two we've had just had round the arena, they were used on sort of light haulage duties. Now, following on, we have an Abelingham Porter steamroller. Now, the steamrollers, as you well know, I'm sure, were used for rolling the roads, farm roads, main roads. This particular example was built by Abelingham Porter at Rochester in Kent. And it's a 1925 example that went new to Clacton Urban District Council in Essex. It's been with the current owner, Alex Baker of Ripley in Derbyshire, for a number of years now. An Abelingham Porter steam tractor this time. This one's owned by Jeff and Janet Lamb from Trowell in Nottinghamshire. It was one of three that were new to Herefordshire County Council. And as I just said, it was for light haulage work. Came into preservation in the 1950s and in the ownership of Jesse Vining in Gloucestershire, and it moved to a gentleman called Jack Hardy up in Sherburn and Albert in Yorkshire. It's been with the current owner in 1997, Jeff and Janet Lamb. Little Foster steam tractor this time by Abigail Ragsdale from Bradford in Nottinghamshire. This one was purchased from a sale as a kit of parts and has meticulously been put back together. It's believed to be one of the first Foster Wellington type tractors to be built. This one went new into Gloucestershire by a gentleman called Lawrence Faulkner. It came into preservation in the early 1960s with a gentleman called Ted Sansom. Ted was a familiar figure at the steam engine rallies, sadly no longer with us. But anyway, Stuart was a gentleman that helped him for many years, and upon Ted and Elsa, his wife, passing, Stuart became the owner of this particular engine. And it actually carries the name of Ted's wife, Elsa. A big Fowler road locomotive now, these big black engine just coming into the arena, built by Fowlers of Leeds. 15462. The 127, it went new to Dalgetty Estates in Hampshire. It's now owned by Steve Arrowsmith from Bart Underneath Wood. Following on an example of a 7 nominal horsepower Alchin traction engine, Alchin has built their engines in Northampton. This is a 1912 example. It went new to a Mr. Hobden in Sussex. First preserved in Oxfordshire, and it's now with Alan Eaton of Creighton near Northampton. 1908 Marshall traction engine, also owned by Alan Eaton. This one goes under the name of Moonlight Rambler. We'll perhaps see some Moonlight Rambling tonight, will we? This one has the works numbers of 4922, and it went new to Tom Stamp of Linwood near Market Raisin. Formed part of the Tom Paisley collection, late 1970s, and it was acquired from his sale in October 1980 by a firm called Park Holland from Stoke-on-Trent. As I say, it's now with Alan Eaton from Creighton. I need eyes in the back of my head here, because I think, you know, they never give in, do they? Hey? Fowler's built various types of ploughing engines, all different, like your cars, like a Ford Fiesta, Ford Escort, Ford Granada. This is a Fowler BB1 ploughing engine called Achilles. It's one of a pair that were built to an order of the Ministry of Munitions and supplied to Watson and Hague of Andover. It then passed to the Honourable B. Butler Henderson in Hampshire, and it's also been owned by, for a spell, by Bonford and Evershed in Hampshire. It's currently owned by Mr. J. Norrish of Langham in Rutland. ...1874 ploughing engine following on behind Achilles. Now you'll know it does it, but we have known to have people thrown off the foot plate tender steering, but we don't want that to happen, do we? But 1874 built. This is one of a pair that worked for Beebe Brothers. It's been with the Hammond family now since 1947. A larger type of ploughing engine, AA7, this before it moved into Lincolnshire, and a Mr. Butler. It's been with the Hammond family since the 1940s, and it's having what you call a very rare appearance at a steam engine rally, so we're both pleased to have that engine with us this weekend. Now we have Sparky with one of our first pair of ploughing engines here this weekend. This one went new to Wards at Carrington Grange. It was built by Fowlers. And these engines are big engines, and they're a great lump to move about on low loaders. So we're very pleased to have such a good turnout of ploughing engines here at Rempstone Steam and Country Show this weekend. Now we have Alma Flair's other ploughing engine, AA7 type engine. This one went new to Lord Rayleigh's estates in Essex. Stewart's driving it for us this weekend. It was later owned by Dr. Coombs in Bedfordshire, and it was acquired by the lady from Fleer of Curtin Lindsay. Garrett's steam tractor this time. This one went new to Saddlers of Stourbridge. If you've been around the rallies for a long time, you'll perhaps remember this one when it was painted yellow and red when it was owned by Alan Tingey from Shackerston. So that's a Garrett steam tractor. Garrett's built their engines at Leiston in Suffolk. It's owned by David Bosworth of Brackley Gate in Derbyshire. And I know that he's had a nice run of about 10 or 12 miles yesterday on the road from Elverston Castle Rally. Foster Showman's engine now, owned by Anthony and Wendy Thompson from West Bridgeford. 1926 example. This one went new to a farmer in the Swansea area. The actual beats of this engine were heard on the Archer's radio programme many years ago when it was owned by Lambs of Bro. And it's been a regular round rally scene since then around the East Midlands. Foster Showman's engine, 1456-4 of 1926. Hutchinson Engineering Services with a Burrell single crank compound Showman's tractor. This one was actually built as a steamroller and it worked for Isaac Ball. Quite a while now. Well looked after, well cleaned. Although I don't think Richard cleans it that much, but does it? Tiff? Yeah, it doesn't clean it that much, Richard. David Paxman. Now this is a rarer type of traction engine. I didn't hear that. Yes, here making a return appearance here with this David Paxman traction engine. David Paxman built the traction engines, well, steam vehicles at Colchester in Essex. This one actually worked in Cornwall. It's been in the Dakin family for quite a while now. I say Cornwall because it's got the registration of AF on it. David Paxman traction engine. On a first time appearance here at Rempstone Steam and Country Show, we have this Avelin and Porter steamroller owned by Mr. Jones from Hereford. Its works number is 10997. This one actually worked on the Lockings estate in Berkshire. And Hugh from Leicester. This one's actually, in the last few years, it was a one-speed engine, just one gear, road gear. It's had a higher gear fitted this time to make it that little bit swifter. It actually went out to work in Sri Lanka, repatriated into this country a few years ago. Now we have the fastest type of steam vehicle on display here this weekend. This is Sentinel's last design of the steam lorry. Sentinel's built their machines at Shrewsbury, and this is an example of an S4 as late as 1933. It's actually worked for Rainfords in the Liverpool area. It's been in the Williamson family now since the very early days of preservation. It's been driven for us this weekend by Mr. Massey. It's travelled on the road from its base, so you could reliably do sort of 30 mile an hour with that. So don't worry if you get stuck behind that one going home tomorrow night. That's the Green Sentinel. Matt Woodbine from Chesterfield next with a Burrell steamroller that actually worked for Isaac Ball of Walls in Lancashire. They were big contractors up that way. Just purchased a few years back by Mal from the Preston area and a gentleman called Anthony Cowles. Avelin and Porter. This one actually worked in the Somerset area. It's owned now at the Stoke Golden Way, and Avelin and Porter, as I say, they built a lot of steamrollers, one of the biggest builders of the steamroller. Long Ashton Rural District Council, Somerset. The Green Steamroller is owned by Fred and Linda Dockray of Long Watton, built by Marshalls, 76116, the maker's number. This one was the first one built by Marshalls to be fitted with their Phaeton radial valve gear. It actually worked in down south, in Somerset area. It's been in the Dockery ownership for quite a number of years now, and over the last few years has received a major rebuild. Crampton family following on with the Wallace and Stevens advanced steamroller. I think when Vaughan brings his engine back out, we'll see a ransom Rolls Royce engine, but yeah. Now we have a Borough Road locomotive, works number 4093, owned by Mr. Smith from Banbury in Oxfordshire, making its debut here at the Rempstone Steam and Country Show. This was actually Burrell's last example. Is there still some more to come? Or are we going to do... There's one more to come. Thank you. 44 is a 6-inch David Brown Cropmaster tractor owned by A. Dawes. I must just stop this one. This is Mr. Brian Wright with a nice little Foster engine. Good afternoon, Brian.
I'm a bit about this one, Brian. It's a 4-inch Foster and it's based on an agricultural engine for threshing.
Nice to see you again. Yeah, good. Yeah, very good. They're up there from the northeast. Yeah. We've not forgot. Garrett without a number. Can you put your number on next time? Let's just have a look. This looks like Team Tricklebank to me.
It is, yeah.
That's it then. I've got it right. It's not bad for a... V8. A 3-inch Fowler, R3 Fowler Showman's engine, R&J Smith. Based on the Iron Maiden, the large showman's engine that is at Scarborough Fair collection of Graham Atkinson's. B1 sneaking by. It's a 3-inch Burrell traction engine owned by Mr. Oliver. B14, where's Charlie today? I know it's Betty, yeah. B14 is a 4-inch Foster owned by Mr. T. Baldwin. And we've got Betty today, we had Charlie last weekend. 27 is a 4-inch Burrell traction engine, GC Satchwell. 6, this is like the lottery, isn't it? Number 6, a 3-inch Elgin traction engine, R Prime. 4.5-inch Burrell. 46. I know this gentleman, Errol. A B2, it's an Atkinson, a 3-inch Atkinson under tight steam wagon. Are you alright, Errol? Have we got it running again? You're in full steam now again, are you? B28 is a 4-inch Foster traction engine, H Cleal. Thank you. Very good, the job of it. Now, Fowler Showman's engine, B32, it's an R3 type Showman's engine. And by J. Ives. This looks the business. Very good, very nice, complete with trailer. You know, I ought to get a ride round on that, didn't I? 36 is a 4.5-inch Burrell traction engine, G. Witham, Ford Elizabeth. And I bet that's the wife's name, isn't it? Are you taking the kids on the way round? I'll just stop this one. Rose, your name?
Jason.
Jason, what scales row?
It's a 4-inch Burrell.
4-inch Burrell. Did you build it yourself?
No, sorry, bought it.
You bought it? Oh, you chickened out. Well done. Your name?
Jason.
Jason, all right, Jason, well done. Oh, it's got a file handle there at the top of the regulator. Right, I know this one. It's a Foster. Vicky Marser. All right, Vicky. Good, I'm all right, thank you, my daughter. Yeah, Vicky used to be the treasurer of the show for many, many years. 20 years, she said. B35 is a 4.5-inch Foden C-type wagon. B Western. 29 is a 4-inch Garrett traction engine, D Wilson. 40, B40 is a 6-inch Foster traction engine, A Simpkins. 26 is Mr. I Paget with a 4-inch Foster traction engine. 26. Well, I knew, ladies and gentlemen, this one would have a number on it, I knew for sure. Mark Adams. Nice little Burrell engine. We've got more miniature engines than you can shake a stick at, and we'll be here till midnight. Just fetch me tea. Now, this is a Tasker Little Giant Type A2. We'll just find out who owns this. And your name is?
I'm Thomas, this is Oliver.
Oh, how old's Oliver?
He's 7.
7, are you training him up, are you?
Yeah, he's better at driving it than me now.
Well, they are, yeah. Nice little Tasker, there we go. Come on then, Oliver, away you go. I know this gentleman. 43 is a Devonshire Burrell engine, and it's owned by Mark Warby, and it's called Fred. All right, Mark. Good. I'll get you promoted back up. Oh, Pete, old friend of mine from many years ago.
Please. Please, man.
23 is a 4-inch Brown and May traction engine. Jay Robinson. Fun. Three of them have been built. This is the third one. Oh right, yeah, there's not an original. There is a Brown and May Showman's engine and a Brown and May tractor, but there's not a Brown and May traction engine surviving on the larger examples. And you ladies and gentlemen, if you're looking towards me. I won't let him in, you know. He can't get up in the morning, that's his trouble, isn't it, James? This is a nice little Garrett Showman's tractor owned by James Ragsdale from Retford in Nottinghamshire. This one actually spent most of its life in Norfolk. It's been acquired by James and the family. It's on its about fourth or fifth year rallying now, and it actually debuted at Elveston Castle some years back. Nice little Garrett Showman's tractor. Don't be late tomorrow, James, else we'll have to fine you. And I knew he'd pass the buck on. He'd blame me for talking to him earlier today. There you are, James Ragsdale, nice little Garrett Showman's tractor. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you all please to give all these engines, men and ladies, big, small engines, whatever, a round of applause for bringing their engines here this weekend to the Rempstone Steam and Country Show. Well done to you all. Well done, everybody. Now, we're going to have a bit of a steam winching demonstration. What are you licking your chops at on that Fowler engine, Ali? What are you? I think we've got two engines. Now, I'm going to stand back while they do the organising. Pull back across the arena, and you think that, you know, you're going to have a good 13-odd ton there to pull back across that arena, so. And just listen to the bark on that single cylinder engine when it techs on. Stewart's engine, it's been around the rally scene for a long time now. While we do this, there's the signal, we're ready to pull. So he's going to take up the strain with a single cylinder ploughing engine now. So that blue Fowler engine that's being pulled back into the arena now, it's fighting against it, but it's not having much effect, is it? And just listen to the bark from the single. Now we're going to clear the tubes out on that single cylinder ploughing engine. Yeah, as much as Stuart tries, he's really trying to fight against it, but not a lot of success. Successful pull. Right, so we're all hitched up. Spark is getting back to his machine. The engine that's doing the pulling this time was a went new to Wards of Carrington in Lincolnshire. It actually worked until 1947 when it was laid up. Pull and more water out of your usage of the engine. It's a bit like when you tweak a car engine, you know. So it was an advancement in the world of steam, and there Stuart's getting the signal. So here we go again for the big pull.
Oh, amazing.